What's going on? Thanks for checking in. I'm here with my friend Gionna Disalvatore. She played at UCLA, professional softball player, one of the best softballers on the planet for a short period of time. And odds have it, she has an incredible kettlebell certification. Okay, so she does a lot of kettlebell work on her own. I figured this time of need, you know, with COVID and all that, guys can't typically get to a weight room. So if they have a kettlebell, you still can get some work in. So she's gonna show you three kettlebell only exercises that's gonna promote on-field baseball and softball performance.
Hey guys, Gionna Disalvatore here, and I have three kettlebell movements that you baseball and softball players can do at any time. Number one, the kettlebell goblet squat. So the squat pattern, very important for athletes to go through. It's a great regression for any squat pattern, especially before loading any athlete under a barbell. And you can do so many different variations with it that'll challenge the athlete in different ways. So as far as the technique goes, you're just gonna clean up the kettlebell and grab the kettlebell by the horns on the side. You want to make sure that your forearms are vertical and the kettlebell is nice and close to your body. If we get out here, we're going to put a lot of pressure on our shoulders, and we don't want that for the athlete. So staying nice and tight, I want you to imagine that you're at the top of a plank, like you're at the top of a pull-up position, and you're going to create and maintain tension throughout the entire movement, which I personally think is under-taught for athletes. You want to teach them how to create the tension and hold the tension throughout the entire movement. As far as our stance, we want to be a little bit wider than shoulder width apart. And when we initiate the bend of our knees are going to bend, and we're going to hinge at the hips at the same time, hit the depth, drive up at the top. Besides the kettlebell goblet squat being a great beginner movement, a regression, and a staple in any athlete's program, it also promotes good posture and position because you are loading the kettlebell in that front rack position. So naturally, the athlete is going to keep their chest up. So build strength, builds power, and then working on the athlete's full range of motion. And then depending on their level, you can do so many different variations. You can do an offset loading, so you could load one side. Again, this is gonna be more demanding on the core with the single-sided loading, or you can double up, have another kettlebell on the other side. And again, this really just depends on the strength and the level of the athlete. All right, second go-to exercise with a kettlebell is the kettlebell swing. Personally, this is my favorite movement. And I feel like a lot of people get confused on whether a kettlebell swing is a squat, because some people tend to be more squatty in their kettlebell movement, when really it's a hinge. So the difference between a squat and a squat, you're gonna have more deviation or bend of the knee, and with the hinge, you're gonna deviate more at the hips. Okay, when setting up for the kettlebell swing, what I have them do is place your hands at your hip crease. I want you to think about shooting your hips back like there's a wall behind you, and you still will have a bend of the knee, okay? When you're in this position, your shoulders are gonna be above your hips, and your hips are gonna be slightly above your knees. We still do want a solid knee bend, because the bend of the knee is gonna have a powerful kettlebell swing. Shallow swing, not a powerful swing, okay? So in this setup position, again, a little bit wider than shoulder width. Depending on your hips will be dependent on how your feet turn out. But again, you want the athlete to have the feet underneath them, because we're not gonna be doing anything from this wide stance on the field, okay? So from here, the setup is your first rep, okay? Take your time setting up. I want you guys to get into that hinge position we were talking about. Tilt the kettlebell. Think about packing your lats. So pulling your shoulder blades down, armpits to pockets. And before you pull it in, I want you to create that tension we were talking about with the kettlebell squat. Get nice and tight, hike past up and above your knees, pop your hips, and back down. That's a drill that you can do to work on the initiation of the swing and that one rep of the swing. So, kettlebell swing, ballistic movement, gonna work on explosive power, gonna strengthen the entire posterior chain of your body. And I want you guys to think about your arms are just noodles with hooks. You're not going to be pulling with your arms. You're just gonna have a strong grip. Keep those lats packed and tight. At the top of the swing, tall standing plank, tight quads, tight glutes, pulling the shoulders back, and allowing gravity to take the bell back down before you drop back to your hinge. So with the kettlebell swing, I want you to really think about the explosiveness of your hips and your knee extension as a power sport. We're doing a lot of things explosively, so really focus on keeping the hips and the knees snappy. And last but certainly not least, something I feel isn't utilized enough is the Turkish getup. A very detailed movement, takes a lot of time for the athlete to understand and learn the steps, which is okay, but make sure you take the time to teach them the step-by-step before loading them up with any weight. The Turkish getup promotes shoulder stability, core stability, spatial awareness, coordination, and as a one-side dominant sport, it's going to expose any asymmetries that the athlete might have, so you're able to tackle those different things and make them better. So before I go through the steps of the Turkish getup, I want you guys to understand, it takes time to learn the steps and you really want to take your time moving through. There's a benefit to each position in each step of the Turkish getup. So when teaching the Turkish getup, it's really important to teach athlete how to get to the starting position safely and correctly. So we're going to start on our side, use this offhand to roll over, and then assist yourself, that offhand, to get it up into that position. You want to make sure that your wrists and shoulder are in line. Again, you wanna also make sure that wrist is in a strong position. From here, you're gonna use this base leg to drive into this left side. So your first move is to drive, okay? The goal is to keep that shoulder in a steady, tight position throughout the entire movement. Always keeping your eyes on the kettlebell. From here, you wanna think about pushing up to that hand and spinning like you're opening up a jar of any sort. From here, you're going to push up with this base leg, drag the foot through and place it right in line with that hand. So it should be nice and stacked in all positions. From here, this is gonna take a little bit of hip mobility. Sink into your hips, then stand up. This is when you can place your eyes forward. Get into a strong position before you stand up into that lunge. Stand up. Once you're here, we're gonna just reverse it from here. Stepping back, placing your eyes back on the kettlebell, windshield wiper this back leg, sink into those hips again, reach out, then shift your weight over that hand. Again, the goal is to stay underneath this kettlebell and stay nice and stacked. From here, we're gonna bring that back leg, swing it through, back down to the forearm, and back down to the back. And from here, make sure you use that offhand, back down safely, and turn over. All right, so a great drill that you can do before loading the athlete while keeping them accountable for the shoulder being in the proper position and their eyes staying on the kettlebell is using a shoe. Grab a sandal, grab a sneaker. You're gonna get down to that same position and you're gonna place the shoe on top of your fist. So from here, just like I showed before, the steps, driving with that off leg, keeping that eyes on the shoe. This is gonna keep your shoulder in the right position and hold you accountable to keeping your eyes on the shoe as well. So from here, get set, step up, and then you would just reverse yourself back down. Okay, this is great. It's gonna hold you accountable to doing all the steps correctly and staying in the right position. The reason why that I fell in love with kettlebells, I got into it once I was done playing. So to fill that void of working on a new skill, this is what excited me, and I pretty much just dove deep into it. And then I actually realized the benefits and how it could translate to on-field performance in baseball and softball players.
All right, there you have it. Appreciate you coming in. Always a pleasure. Hey, I take care of you guys, right? Everybody's been DMing me about kettlebell workouts. To be completely honest with you, I've never been, you know, too crazy about implementing kettlebell style stuff. But now, you know, times are changing. Guys can't get to a weight room. I believe a kettlebell is very good for, you know, teaching that hinge pattern. You know, with the kettlebell goblet squat, you can increase muscle hypertrophy, range of motion, and then nothing like a Turkish get up for shoulder stability. You know, I know Cressy over there uses it for a lot of his pro pitchers, so it's really good for overall stability of the shoulder and to the core throughout multiple planes of motion, right? So hey, when I don't know too much about a subject like kettlebells, I'll always bring in a professional for you guys. So if you could, please do me a favor and subscribe for me. I pump out two of these videos per week, just trying to help out, guys. Catch you next week. Hey, at the end of the day, nobody's grinding like us, man. Everything I do, I be tipping the head. My youngin' got no body, she's still pissing the bed. Keep the call to silence, don't repeat what I said. Welch sets one down the line and left. Clearing the seats. I'ma let him spin like a spiral. Let's go. Put him on the news, he went viral. Smiling, yeah, ain't got turn him on.
I hit all the vibes on the low cause I'm a sniper.